Can anybody see anything? Can anyone hear anything? Alright, so apparently Matthew can see and hear something. So can Marcus. Alright, that's a start. Okay. We may be fighting this all night, I have no idea. But it will prevail until I get too irritated and decide to cut it off and go to bed or something, I don't know. I changed the camera angle and the resolution just a little bit. I'm hoping that will give it... Is anybody out there able to see this in anything other than 360? Just out of curiosity, because what I'm getting on my YouTube, all I can see is 360p. But I'm broadcasting according to my software in 1080p. And so, I don't know what the problem is. Alright. I'm just going to keep painting and just see what happens. By the way, the reason I'm doing the black so much here is because what I'm using right now, anyway, is the Scale 75 black. And while I'm a big fan of the Scale 75 paints, I talked about them in the last live stream, for some reason the black, I've had a lot of trouble with it covering really well. It tends to be very chalky. And so I'm trying to give it some chances here, but I gotta tell you, the Vallejo black is it seems to be anyway, a much better black. The remainder of the Scale 75 paints that I've dealt with so far are pretty good, but the black seems to experience some problems. Let's see here, 360 here. Not a biggie, painting at the moment as well. Might be dropping a bit while streaming, but when the videos on YouTube are so long, compiling at higher resolutions. Oh, okay, well maybe that's something. Alright. Good evening, Jonathan. How are you today? Face itself is actually pretty good right now, so I'm going to leave the face as it is. I say that, there's probably going to be a big white spot somewhere around here that I haven't seen yet, like that one on the leg right there. And the one on the inside of this leg. Japers. But, let's paint this guy's eyes. How about that? And I think, since he's basically a cat, let's give him some kind of greenish-yellow eyes. That'll be fun. Okay, I need a color. And I think this will work just well, actually. Considering I wanted greenish yellow, and this is called yellow green. It's a good start. Ah, sorry to hear that you're sick, man. I'm right there with you on work, only my work is in about 8 hours, so. I will feel your pain with you. Just a little bit. Alright. Let's see if we can do some neon green eyes on this dude. Where is a smaller brush, though? I want a smaller brush. Let's grab this one. Okay. Grab a little bit of that paint. Need some water in that paint, though. Where's everybody from, by the way? I always like to ask that. It's curious to know. It's kind of one of those fun facts. Okay, let's see if we can do this here real quick. Blob. There we go. Perfect eyeball. Alright. Let's do the other side, shall we? Kerplunk. Outstanding. Finland. Wow. I don't think I've seen anyone from Finland on here, so welcome. I do not speak Finnish, so I cannot give you a standard Finnish greeting. I apologize. Matthew G gets off for Canada Day. Alright. From Toronto. Cape Cod, Ma. Never been to Cape Cod. Alright, where's my black? There it is. This is called Fixing Your Screw-Ups. Intentional as they may be. Alright. Get some paint going here. Hey, what's up? Swimming in Mountain Dew has arrived. Everybody tell Jason they want him to do videos again. We missed them.
I missed the eyeball up.
That's all right. I'll deal with it for now. Fine. We'll fix it. We'll fix it. Don't worry. It'll get better. Maybe. Probably not. That didn't turn out too bad. You may miss them. Alright. I tell you, I don't know, been a long time since I picked up the paintbrush. Still have the lamp that was on. Still have the lamp. She was on your table. Okay. I tell you who I really miss, and I wish they would do videos again, was this guy years ago on YouTube named Stumpy Thumper. Had some fantastic videos and just disappeared one day. No idea where he went. No idea what he's doing now, but he's gone. Oops. I cut into the eyeball. Oh, okay, gotcha. Roman Gladiator Commission, alright. I have not done that many historical miniatures. I had one guy here locally that commissioned me to paint a bunch of, like, 72mm old school. I mean, really old school, like, solid lead stuff. years ago. And that went on for, oh, I don't know, a year and a half, 2 years. That's really the only historical stuff I've ever done. I have difficulty wanting to pick up a historical miniature just because of the nature of, oh my God, what did I do? The nature of having to have everything mostly historically accurate, so. Alright, let's fix that eye. This is why I do the eyes first. I mean, this is, it's so freaking tedious. Okay, do I need to redo the left eye? Slightly, yes. Okay, maybe I can thin it back out. You know what? Screw it. I'm just gonna do the whole eye. Why not? There. Fine, who cares? It's not like I've been doing this for 2 hours and haven't made it past the eyeballs yet. Solid lead British Empire stuff, cool. You remember Stumpy? He was a good guy. You remember Dale? I can't remember what Dale's username was. Oh, fudge. Bootleg tattoo, bootleg painting. He was always a fun guy to watch, too. Alright, let's try the eyes again. One more time. Let me get a little more water in my brush to make sure that it flows off easier. Okay. Vertical eyelid. There we go. Not a vertical eyelid. That'd be really freaking weird. Okay. I think we're good. I got it. Perfect. Now I just gotta clean them up. Why, thank you, Matthew. My tutorials are the best, by the way, if anybody's wondering. And I'm extremely humble, too. Although, admittedly, I would avoid, like, the very first stuff that I did. Not necessarily, I mean, like, avoid it. There's still some good stuff in there, but half the time is spent, like, off the camera. Because I had nobody filming me. It was all done by myself. So. Alright, I believe that gives us a really, really awesome looking, can I please have a better focus? There we go, that's pretty good. That's pretty darn cool, I like that. Yeah, Dale was always a little bit on a little high, yeah. Let's see here, terrain guy, terrainaholic, yeah. I met Bill one time up at Origins. No, I take it back. It was Origins 1 year. And real nice guy. Super nice. Sue was real nice as well. Very short. She's actually shorter than she looks in the videos. Real nice people. All right, let's cap that brush. Let's see here. A lot of those YouTubes are on Twitch. Really? Oh, that's cool. Your partners with Bill? That's pretty cool. Is it you do the minis, he does the terrain? Alright, let's see here. Let's do the hair next, because that's going to be the next messiest step. And let's see what we can do with that. So, first of all, let me coat between the fingers here on the spear. There we go. I still see some white specks in the hair. I hate that. Okay, so we're making some progress. That's good. By the way, if anybody is interested in kind of the way I'm going to go with this guy, most everything on this model is going to be dark. Basically, what you see right now and the additional weapon over here, which I should have probably painted with the brown when I had it mixed, is going to be relatively dark. In fact, I'll probably coat this brown section with a brown wash at some point, or a brown glaze to bring it back even darker. But then the robes here, the spear, the other weapon are all going to be kind of a red and a gold. Let me get my my reference photos out here, or my reference stuff. So, stupid as it may be, I like to use magic cards and or other trading cards or pieces of art as my inspiration. So I really love this piece of art right here. I mean, it's absolutely gorgeous. The way the golds and the reds kind of blend together, just beautiful. And then there's this one here, which is another really cool piece of art, but I like the way the gold and the blue kind of plays together on this one. Not so much the red. The red's a little pink in this one, although it does kind of work well, but the reds and the golds here work really well. They're kind of orangish red. So what I'm going to do is kind of an orange red on the main larger piece of cloth down here. Probably a blue of some kind on this piece of cloth, not quite sure what. And then a lot of gold filigree all over this guy. And I think that between the I think between all three of those colors, I think it's going to give us some real cool contrast. Yeah, you can post Bill's site in here, that's fine. I have no problem with that at all. Alright, let's see here. Okay. You know, these white specks, I tell you, I'm going to have a fit one of these days. You're looking at it pretty much dark gray, almost black. Yeah, this guy was white when I started, so I've been base coating him for like an hour. I'm using this scale 75 stuff, and it's like I said, the rest of their colors that I've used are really, really good, but the black is just, everything comes out chalky. It's like a, it's like got a gray haze to everything. So I'm having to coat it 3, 4, 5 times just to get a good solid base coat with the black. I've never had to do that with any of their other colors before. All right. Good morrow from the U.S. It won't let you post it. That's weird. Very strange. Use painted models for inspiration, like different schemes, army stuff, and line running. Long time ago, you took us on a car trip to a place I had for fried chicken. What city and state? What was it called? Oh, excuse me, I'm yawning. That was Lambert's Cafe in Foley, Alabama. There are, if I recall correctly, I believe there are three Lambert's Cafes in the United States. One's in Alabama, one I think is in Michigan, and I can't remember where the other one is. But there are, it's not quite a chain, but there are multiple versions, or there's multiple locations. I definitely wouldn't refer to it as a chain restaurant. Just out of curiosity, morbid curiosity, because I like to see kind of what my efforts do, is anybody in the chat right now here from a forum where I posted that this live stream was going to be happening? Anybody at all? Or is everybody here from YouTube because you saw that I was doing a YouTube video? Let's see if I can find Bill's site real quick. Hang on. And I'll post it myself. If I can. I don't even know if I can post it, to be honest with you. Let's see here. Google.com. Are you talking about his .webs page? Oh, yeah, that'll work. There, I can post it. Well, that's a different site, but yeah, basically the same thing. Alright. Okay, so where to go next? I think now I think I'm going to start working on the long fur. That would be the head, or the hair, I guess. Nope. What's nope? Something doesn't work. I get really distracted when I do these live streams, I swear. Alright. Okay, so I need some grays. Let's deal with the grays real quick. Well, do I want to do gray? Because the whole skin's going to be gray. Let me think about this for a second. Okay, the skin's gonna have to be really, really dark. So the fur needs to be not quite as dark, I guess. I'll go up to London. That's London Grey, not London, UK, by the way. Since we do have someone in here from the UK, don't want you to get confused. Alright, black grey, that's a start. And then let's do dark grey. And then I'll mix some London into that, and we'll cross our fingers. No. Well, it's not quite true. I have the vast majority of the scale 75 range, but I don't have everything. I only have one set of the game color type stuff. I can't remember what their version of, like, Vallejo's game color is, and it is not good paint. However, their scale range, I do have the vast majority of those paints. The only problem that I've got with them is that it's very difficult to buy them individually. You have to buy them in sets, and that kind of sucks. Alright, I need some gray. Let's do this. That's enough lollygagging. Here's some gray. Perfect. Perfect. Haha, see what I did there? I'm retarded. Okay. Only got the flesh set? Alright. I can definitely highly recommend the metallic colors in scale 75. They're absolutely amazing. I'm going to be using several of them a little bit later on today, actually, as I move into the weaponry. They are unbelievably stunning. I mean, just fantastic. Cannot recommend them enough. Hey, don't fall over. P3 paints. I actually have a box of P3 paints that I have never opened. Shame on me. Is that a goatee? I can't tell. Okay. That's actually pretty good where it is right there. That's not too far off from where I want to end my highlight on this fur. Dark Star Molten Metal. Alright, let's put that in there. Love the Vallejo Air Metallics. I've actually never used any of the Vallejo Air stuff, namely because I don't have an airbrush, and so if you name something air, I kind of feel like I need to use it in its proper method of distribution. Alright, get a little more of this scrubbed off the brush. And let's see what I can do with this. I really want to focus just on the upper section now. Don't want to really do anything beyond that. So I am the sun, I shine down on the miniature. I only touch what I can see, right? That's kind of the rule. The little cheek fur right there, that's kind of cool. Ta-da! And then rinse that out. And get a little London gray. That's dark gray. Learn to read. That's really bright compared to the others, but that's okay. Because I'm going to use it sparingly. Alright, let's do it. We're gonna do it! Do it live! Just ever so gently. Just a couple of places. Just poking it in. I don't want this everywhere. Just a little bit here and there. Perfect. Alright. I may have to dull a lot of that down here very soon, but I don't know. We'll see how it turns out in the end. This kind of down here, you know, it looks stupid, but, I mean, when you look at it, the light would stop right here. There's like a definitive break line that would happen because the hair curls under, but it looks dumb when you actually do it to the miniature. I don't know. Maybe I can make it work. Who knows? Let's go back to the black, though. Burn it out. Alright. More black. Put that there and grab the brush again. By the way, if I don't answer your comment or question or anything quickly, it's because I'm keeping track of the stream mostly through OBS Studio, which is the software I've got to use to actually render the stream. YouTube has about a 10-second delay, so I can't really see if I'm in frame when I'm painting until it's a little too late. I have to kind of flick back and forth between the two. Uh-oh, I missed cleaning up part of the eyeball. Shame on me. Let me do that real quick. There we go. I think that's good. Alright, and let's make sure to get the bottom lip, please. Perfect. Alright, I have to take this model away from the camera for just a second so I can actually see what I'm doing. Incredibly dark. That's okay, that's kind of the way I want it. Come around and we'll get the shoulders and everything here. Come back in and get the ears one more time, since I pretty much completely destroyed them. Out of curiosity, is the model in focus for you guys? Because every time I go to the menu where I can change how well this camera focuses, it actually modifies the screen that I see to be about 18,000 times smaller than it is right now, and I can never tell if the thing is focused. So, feel free to let me know if it's focused or not. Okay. Oh, good lord, there's a bunch of messages. I have not dealt with Dark Star paints before. I don't care if you do a shameless plug, that's fine. Yep. That's perfectly fine. As long as it's to something that is, you know, like, morally sound. Have I worked with any of the anthropomorphic miniatures from Dark Star Miniatures? What do I think of them? I have two. I have never actually painted them. One of them has been sitting on my, on a shelf, actually, in completely cleaned up mode. Has been, had the flashing and everything taken off of it. I may have even primed it. I don't remember. It's one of, like, the mouse. In fact, I'll go get it. Hang on one second. We'll just go grab it. It's not yet primed. I was wrong. It's this little guy. I do love this guy. It's fantastic. I've got this guy, and then I've got, like, there's a tortoise monk that that I have, and it is really, really beautiful. I love this line. I've just never gotten into it, which is sad. I may do this guy next. Who knows? I love the wood grain here too. So beautiful. It's just absolutely just so well done. But great line. Yes, I highly encourage people to check it out. It's actually one of the really only miniatures from Dark Sword that I like. I'm not a huge fan of their artist line of stuff. Most of what I've seen is a little too thin for me. I'm not a real big fan of spindly miniatures, and all of their artist stuff seems to be very, very, let's see, very easily breakable looking. So, but their anthropomorphic line is just gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Use that blue tack to get some of the other blue tack off of the base. There we go. Good enough. Alright. Let's see what we can do about putting some skin tone on this guy. And I'm going to start things out. You know, I'm probably going to use the exact same set of colors I just used to do the hair. The only difference being that in the end, I'm probably going to wash them. Or glaze them, depending on how you want to phrase it. I guess it really depends on what tool you're using. Okay. So, let us pray that this works well. Please, dear God, let this work fine. Alright, let's try that. And it's shockingly gray and very, very bright. Woo! That's a bit much. That's okay. That's all right. We will prevail somehow. And I'm gonna keep going temporarily at least. Just to see what happens. I'm gonna do like maybe the peck and then maybe the abs or something, and if it doesn't work, we'll start over again. Never be afraid to say, you know what? I screwed up. My model sucks. Okay, a little more paint. Let's see, where am I out of? I am in Birmingham, Alabama. It's the southern version. Not to be confused with Birmingham, England. The beginning of the video. What miniature am I working with? James, I am working with a Harbinger of Bast, or Basti, from the War Gods of Egyptus line from Crocodile Games. That's the name of the model right there. It's the male version. There is a female version. I chose not to do that one because she's very nude. It's by a sculptor named Todd Harris. I don't recall having ever done anything by him before. If you're interested, though, check crocodilegames.com out. They have an amazing, amazing line of miniatures. I always recommend them to people whenever somebody's looking for something cool and out of the ordinary. Okay, so let's do this ab here. And maybe the oblique. just a little bit. And these muscles that don't really exist, well, I guess these are kind of still obliques. Sort of, but not really. That looks hideous. Alright, dark gray. Trust me, it's horribly, horribly bright. It's nowhere near black, which is what I'm going for. Because I'm going for really more of a, not necessarily a gray color, but sort of a black that appears to be reflecting light. So we'll see how it turns out. I'm going to do one half of the model here very, very quickly. Just to see how it turns out, and if it doesn't turn out well, then I'll change, I'll rebase coat and change what I'm doing. Okay, let me do the abs here. Went to boot camp down here. Interesting. Didn't realize there were any military encampments down here. I guess up in Anniston, yeah. I mean, there's the Army Depot and the massive weapons storage. All right, and let's go with London Gray next. Ah, okay, in Georgia. All right. Let's see here. Ooh, that's really, really, really bright. Oh, Lord. Just ballparking in some colors. Don't worry about it. It's going to look like garbage. I know. I do not have any paints from Secret Weapon at all. No. Alright. So, let's attempt to make a glaze. I'm going to switch to Vallejo Black on this one because I don't trust the scale to make a good glaze. It might, I don't know, but I'm not gonna risk it right now. I know Vallejo works. So that's what we're going with. Let's make a glaze, shall we? About 800 drops of water to every one drop of paint. Alright, we'll try that. See what happens. Alright, let's just... Okay... A little more paint in the brush, please. Very, very dark. I'm sorry. Still very, very light. I'm looking at my black paint thinking, wow, that's really dark. Okay, I'm going to let that dry, and then I'll apply another layer of the glaze. Jeez. meant the South in general. Ah, gotcha, yeah. Yeah, I don't usually use washes. I have some, but for the most part, I like control. And the only way I get control is if I make it myself. So, let's see now. I'm going to continue working, but I'm going to let that glaze dry temporarily, and while it's drying, I'm going to put a little bit of red on the miniature, kind of move forward, if I can get the bottle open. Good gosh. Alright, that's good enough. It's not exactly what I wanted to have happen, but I will take it. Entire cap came off of the eyedropper bottle. That's okay. Set that in there. And then I need to combine something with it. Whoops, hello, sorry. Bumping the camera. Ooh, I know what to combine with it. I'm gonna try it with something to combine with it. Let's see here. It could work. Oops. Is just me experimenting with some stuff. I don't know if it's going to work or not, but I'll give it a go. I don't mind trying. Okay. Let's just see what this looks like. Yeah, it looks pretty much like I thinned it with a wood grain medium. Okay. That's a little on the brown side. Let's add some more red. See what happens. These spinning paint holders. I gotta tell you, those things are a pain in the butt to find. The War Store used to have them very consistently. I have not seen them on there for a while. I finally got in touch with the manufacturer, and I actually sell them now because I got to where I could not find them anywhere in the U.S. and people kept asking me where to buy them. So I sell them, but they're made by a company called Vatican Enterprises. I don't honestly know of anybody in the U.S. that still sells them right now. Like I said, the War Store used to carry them, but they have not had them in a very, very long time. In fact, I think they took them off their website. That's right, we never make mistakes, we just have happy accidents. Let's paint a little happy orc or happy gene stealer. Just claw your face out. But he's happy, and that's the important part. Maybe we can paint some happy little clouds around him. I love Bob Ross. He's an awesome guy. The skin is not looking horrible now with that glaze on there. It still needs a little bit of extra work, but that's all right. Let's see here. Who do you kill for one? Well, nobody, I hope. Although I got a list of folks that, you know, if you really want, you know, something to do, if you're bored one day, feel free, let me know. If you want a paint rack, though, if you want to buy one from me, you can head over to my website, agpminis.com. They're on there. I can't remember how much I've got them priced at, but they are there. And you're welcome to one. I think I've got 8 left right now. Or is it 7? I think it's 8. That's still too brown. Gosh darn it. I swear. One of these days I'm going to learn how to paint. Let's do the back, see what it looks like. Yeah, it still looks like crap. Alright, so red by itself is not going to function well. Let's try dark red. I tell you what, do I want to just do flat red straight out? Let's try. Let's try black red and flat red mixed together. Alright, cool. By the way, if anybody wants to order anything, if you feel like supporting the channel, feel free to do so. I am in the market for a new laptop. Gotten to the point where I've got the filming down pat, but being able to edit stuff has become a major bottleneck, so I need a secondary laptop to edit things through. So. How did I decide on my color scheme? James, actually, let me show you what I showed a little earlier. This one came from a couple of cards, actually. A couple of little small pieces of art here. These happen to be magic cards, although I love using any kind of trading cards with art on them. Just a quick, cheap, easy way to get a lot of different little pieces of art by different artists. So I love the play of the golds and the brownish reds in here. So that's kind of what I'm going for on the robes. That's going to be the front and the back robes back there. And then I love the play with the blue and the gold here. I'm not too wild about the pink right here in the center, but I love darker blue and then the almost the purple here. And then the gold works really well. So the center... this center piece of cloth there, that's actually going to end up being blue in the end, and then a lot of gold filigree all over the place. So that's kind of what I was going with when I picked out the color design for this this miniature. Hopefully it'll work. We'll find out, won't we? Alright. Okay, so we're just going to try this instead and see how this works out. I'm going to cross my fingers and hope for the best. Actually, before I do that, let's go back to the black and add another layer of glaze. I'm still not committing to painting the skin tone in this color yet until I can see whether or not it's going to work. I mean, it's looking good. I like the fact that it's nice and it's dulled down some, but it's still really, really bright, I feel. I don't know. It may work, though. We'll let that one dry. That's, I think, 3 different sets of glazing, and I'll make a decision after that. How about it? All right, Sir Lathan. Have a lovely, lovely evening, or morning, depending on, I guess, since you're in Massachusetts, it's probably Is it Massachusetts or Maryland? I think it's MD's Maryland, so you're in Massachusetts. So it's like 2 o'clock in the morning, so yes, get to bed and get to work early, and don't get fired because of me. That'd be bad. Oh, that's so much better. Oh, wow, that's just, oh, it's just fantastic. Okay, now I feel better. I feel better. I'm not having anxiety attacks about the red anymore. Wonderful. Not actually going to paint the red, I'm just kind of laying the color in so that I know how everything is going to play together once the colors get laid on here. So I just want to lay it in and I'll come in, I'll paint the legs and everything, and then I'll come back in after I'm done with all that and do the highlights on the red here. But yeah, that's so much better. That brown weird blood color I had going. It would have been a good color for blood, but definitely not for the red that I was going for. It just didn't work. Now back here, it really needs to be darker because this whole area is going to be in shadow. But we'll cross that bridge when we arrive there. For now, though, it's getting painted the same color. How the heck is everybody, by the way? I don't know how many people are in the room, but if I haven't said hi to you, good morning or good evening. I think there's still some people on the West Coast and in Hawaii that it's still evening time for them, so whatever greeting works for you. Be dipped if that red didn't bleed over into the skin. Shame on that. Stupid color. That's alright, we can fake it till we make it. By painting a big ring to make it look like that's what I intended to do. Perfect. Ish. Well, that was uncalled for. I'm just slopping the paint on now. I'm not even paying attention, apparently. Painting in the lines is for losers. Alright. That's not bad. I can deal with all that. That's pretty darn good. Not to like toot my own horn or anything, but I like that color combination. That works very well. And looking at the skin tone, I think I can deal with that as well. I will need to probably lighten the hair a little bit. Because it is very, very similar to the skin tone. But overall, I think it's going to work. So, let me rebase coat the skin that I've painted in black and then start over and do it right this time with good blending and hopefully it'll look good. Alright, so let's thin this out just a bit. Okay, perfect. There we go. So I'm just going to paint over everything I just did. And we'll come back in and I'll do it the right way this time. More than three layers. Lots of good solid blending. And it'll look nice, hopefully. It's interesting, like the advertisement model version of this guy, the one that's there, the picture that's on their website, it was painted by Marika Reimer, who's, in my opinion, one of the best painters out there right now, or was. I don't know if she still paints or not. I'm sure she does. But when she painted this miniature years and years and years ago, I think they... this model came out back in like 2004, 2005. She painted it using really bright tones. I mean, just shockingly bright skin, like almost like a yellowish brown type skin. And the model looked great, but I never really wanted to do that that bright color scheme. It's one of the few models that I have that I saw it and I didn't think to myself, you know, this would look good if it was painted like a clown. And if you followed my YouTube stuff for a while, most of you guys know I love my bright colors. But this guy just seems to lend himself to a good dark skin tone. Just a kind of that, you know, when you think of an Egyptian cat, you think of a black cat most of the time. You don't think of a like a tabby cat or an orange tom or something like that. It's always just a black cat sitting somewhere. That's always what I wanted to do with this guy. Never did get around to him, though. Until now. Alright. So, let's let that dry. I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to take a small break while that skin tone or that fur, short fur is drying. And I will come back in like, I don't know, 10 minutes or so. I'm going to go get myself a Snickers or something that can soothe my tummy, which seems to be calling for food. So, give me a couple minutes and I shall return. Don't go anywhere. Don't touch that dial. I'll be back in two and two, as Chuck Willery used to say. Anyone still in the chat? Let's see. Lost a couple people, and I've lost a bunch of stream strength, too, apparently. I guess when the stream is... Or when I'm not doing anything on video, maybe the stream strength goes down. That's retarded. Whatever, though. Alright, who's still here? I am. Temporarily, at least. Hopefully for a while. Let's see. Alright, so let's start this again. Now that I know what the hell I'm doing. And let's go with black-gray. But I need a mid-tone color between that and black, so we'll mix some black into it. Let's just dab some of that right there. And I'll grab some black as well. And let's mix them together. Where's my mixing brush? That's right here. That is definitely not dark enough. There we go. Better. Oops. Hello. A little of that on my my paint carousel. Okay, there we go. Ah, that's much better. Nice deep black color. Alright. With a smaller brush. Let's work the face this time. Well, no, I'll tell you what. Let's work on the same areas we did previously. I'll gingerly work my way up to a highlight color. Using a smaller brush this time. I want much more control than I had the last time I did this. I was just kind of ballparking it last time to see if the colors would even work. And they did, which was nice. Hey, James. Very welcome. Hopefully this will be available later. Yes, I think last time I did this, I want to say it was about a day, maybe a day and a half, before YouTube got it uploaded. But it should be available. They do auto-record all these things, so it should be available on the channel. I do appreciate you dropping by, James. Thank you very much. Hey, have a good evening. Get some sleep. Especially if you're one of the unlucky few like myself that has to work tomorrow. I agree. Sleep is this, like, very annoying thing that gets in the way of me doing stuff. So is that thing that I gotta do called a job. It's just a waste of frickin' time. It just gets in the way of all the cool stuff. Actually, years ago when I had, quote-unquote, retired, when I was 25, I did a lot of research on various sleep patterns, and I never did try it out, but I was always intrigued by what was deemed Da Vinci sleep. Apparently Da Vinci, in order to experience the most out of life and not miss anything, came up with this idea or this pattern of sleeping where you would essentially take a 30-minute nap every 6 hours. And so during an entire day, you would really only sleep for 4 hours. And he said, or his idea was that was all man really needed to function at a decent level. And he did it for a while, from what I read, but I suppose in today's society, especially if you're working, it's going to be nigh on impossible to do something like that. Not too bad. I'm pleased with the way that looks. I'm gonna go ahead and do that inside of the neck area as well. And probably just leave that as it is, just as its own little highlight. Okay. So now what I'll do is I'll take a little bit more of that black gray and I'll add that in to my current mixture. Oh gosh, I've got paint all over myself. That's not good. It will come out with Clorox. I've heard similar things, Matthew. I think honestly, it would be more of an inconvenience to the flow of life more than anything now, as opposed to something that would impact your health in a negative way. I bet if we were all still farmers and you know, hunter gatherers, you could probably function that way fairly well. But since most of us have to work from 8 to 5, it makes things difficult. Some of us get the joy of working from 8 until 7:30, 8, 9 o'clock at night. How exciting. What opportunities. Can you feel my enthusiasm? Abdominal muscles. Actually, it's really abdominal muscle. There's only one. It just looks funny. I'm actually quite fortunate in that arena. I have trained myself to where I can fall asleep anywhere at any time. It's just a matter of changing my breathing pattern and keeping my eyes closed. I tend to, when I'm at work, I'll use one of my two lunch breaks and I'll eat a quick bite to eat, and then usually, so I have a two-seater car, I can't really put the seat back, so I just sort of lay my head back and breathe in a particular pattern, and within, I don't know, 5 minutes, I'm gone. Probably not even five, to be honest with you, in most days. Think of all the cool stuff you'd get done. I mean, honestly, working is one of those things, and I've got no problem with, you know, providing for your family and all that kind of stuff, but I think we put so much of an emphasis today on working for someone as opposed to providing our own way. But imagine if you didn't have to deal with that. Let's suppose you worked a normal 8 hours, and you didn't have, you know, a crazy company that you work for, something like that. Imagine what you could do with that 8 hours every single day. And I'm not even talking about, like, you know, quote-unquote fun stuff. I'm talking about things that are truly important. Imagine spending an extra 8 hours every day, you know, teaching and nurturing your children, or cultivating an incredible relationship with the woman that you love. Learning a new language, you know, so many things that we could do that would enhance society, honestly. But we're stuck in this sort of rut of, you know, I've got to go to work so I can make money to provide for my family. And, you know, when you really think about it, do we really need to provide as much as we think we do? Or would it be better for us to move to a farm and do things the old way? Or the way the Amish still do them? I don't know. It's always one of those things I've kind of pondered. Alright, straight black gray this time, I think. Stuck my finger in a bunch of paint. That was good. Oh, I agree, definitely. I work at a very strange environment. I work for an automotive manufacturer, and I cannot count on my fingers and my toes the number of people in that place who are on their third, fourth, fifth marriage. Imagine all the lives that have been touched and damaged during those events, you know? And a lot of it is due to the fact that people value that career or that job in that industry more than they value their family. And that's not, you know, against anyone or saying something bad about somebody that feels like that, but, you know, we kind of forget that our actions affect others sometimes. That's true, if you do love your work. I found very few people that do love their work, though. Like, I love doing this. This is, for me, this is not work. And sometimes it does pay the bills. Sometimes it doesn't. Pay the bills all the time, that'd be great. But, unfortunately, it does not right now. All right. Yeah, just a little bit more. I don't even think I'm going to go all the way up to London Gray. I don't think I need it. It is. Many times, unfortunately. Okay. This is actually turning out pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. I actually really like the way this is going. Now, that's all gonna be darkened down here, because otherwise it's gonna be, like, insanely bright. But, it's definitely going in a good direction. Pick up a little bit of this color straight out of the bottle. Let's see what we can do with it. Maybe just kind of an edge highlight up here on the pecs. Not quite an edge highlight. Not yet, maybe. I don't know. Oops, I need less paint in the brush. And I need to make little streaky marks, otherwise it's gonna mess things up. Okay. little bit more of this black gray back in down here. I think the abs got a little bit too highlighted. There we go. Better. Alright, so now, do I really even want to go to London Gray? Not really, not here. I think we're fine, actually. So I think I'm going to stop with the what is this, basalt gray? No, dark gray. Okay. We'll stop there. I'll make a nice clear line here across the peck. And underneath the peck, we will leave in the previous color. Alright. That's pretty good. Oops, hello. I hit the camera. Sorry. And then I'm going to use the black instead of actually painting this back in. I'm just going to use this glaze that's been sitting here and still hasn't dried. We'll see if this works. If it doesn't work, I'll come in with the black paint. And I think I'm going to have to come in with the black paint. I was going to ring the abs. But, I don't know. May not work. Let's see. Am I even on the camera? Probably not. We drew a plus sign. Let's fix that, please. Well, that's actually really freaky. Look at that, from the underside, there's like no highlight at all. Weird. And then you spin him. Ta-da! Now he's all bright and shiny. Alright. Greetings from Greece. Greetings from America. I like the Greeks. I like any country whose heroes that they look up to are like, you know, mythic legends. Here in America, we've got, you know, the founding fathers and things like that, and you know, Mexico, you've got revolutionaries and things like that. But you go to Greece and you've got all kinds of cool gods and things to look up to. And I mean, you know, I'm a Christian myself, so I have the God, but you know, it's interesting just thinking about Greek mythology, and especially I really like Nordic mythology as well. But I was reading a very fascinating book about the invasion of the Isle of Crete, and one of the things that it talks about is when Greek children grow up, they're you know, taught to look up to these mythical heroes of old and model themselves after these great heroes, and kind of makes things interesting, creates a very, very hardy people. Alright, let's do now, let's do a little more red. Do I still have any of that mixed up? I do. And maybe while that black is drying on my palette, I can do the red. Okay. Sorry for being quiet. Sometimes I just kind of like to go with the flow of painting. Sometimes there's no need to talk. Let's do, let's see here, what shall we do next? Let's figure out what blue to use, how about that? Let's go to the paint carousel, see what to use. I think we've got, let's see, the red is going to turn pretty bright, so the blue may want to fit in that same category. Dark blue? No. Maybe intense blue. That'd be kind of fun. Maybe an off-color blue would be good. Let's try Andrea blue. That's always a fun blue to use. This is probably going to be excruciatingly bad. But we'll try it and see what happens. This is one of my favorite colors from the Vallejo line of paints, and I rarely ever use it. But it is gorgeous. Think it's gonna be too bright. That's definitely too bright. I still feel like it's a little too bright, though. We'll see. Gives me an idea of what might go there, though, at least. So, we'll leave it for right now. Alright, where to go next? I feel like I should do the arms next, or the back. The back's probably going to be the next easiest section to do, so let's do the back. So I need to go back to the black gray and remix it. I got, I think, three of these. So we'll do that. We'll add in some black into that. Chat has gone quiet, it seems. Is everybody still here? Anybody still here? Not that I'm, like, you know, really in a talkative mood if anybody doesn't want to talk, but I am curious just to make sure that everything is still on the up and up as far as the stream goes. Because you never know when something's going to fail. You just never know. Let's switch brushes too on this one. Alright, there's a couple people. I see the 11, but you never know if there's some kind of weird glitch where people are trying to talk to me and my chat box is not working or something. I don't know. You never know. It's YouTube. They do weird stuff. Wanna do the shoulders yet? Yeah, I'll go ahead and do the shoulder as well. Why not? I've got the paint out. I may as well do it. After I finish this coat, I'm going to take a very small break to stand up and give my gluteus maximus a bit of rest. Do a quick 5-minute yoga session. How about that? Hadn't said it in a while, I don't think, but shameless self-promotion. If anybody's interested in picking up a DVD to help out the channel, head over to the website, agpminis.com. Got a huge line of how to paint DVDs over there. Not like actually how to paint DVDs, because that'd be like a weird product, but DVDs that teach you how to paint. So if you like what you see, I have a very good ability to communicate how I do what I do. And if you're interested in learning how to do it, definitely check them out. Helps me out, helps the channel out, and I would greatly appreciate it. Trying to fund a new laptop so I can edit more videos for you guys. Good morning, Omaha. How are you, sir? Or madam? Not really sure. I'm assuming sir because like 90% of my audience is male. So I'm just going to go with sir for right now. If I'm wrong, please correct me. And I'm sorry. Tea and toast, my goodness, you are definitely from the UK. That's about the most British thing that could have been said in this chat. Unless you had said something about tea and crumpets instead. But that's okay. Everywhere has their little quirks. And I mean everywhere. I love sort of learning about various cultures' unique traits. So it's always fun to hear, you know, what people eat or the way people speak or the phrases that people use or things like that. It's always just fascinating to me. If you're hearing an echo, it's probably because I have my sound on my computer turned up. Had a little conversation, wasn't really a conversation so much as it was a statement, towards the beginning of the stream, where I talked about that very thing. I don't tend to wear headphones because I don't like blocking out the outside world. I like to be aware of my surroundings, and I don't like having one of my senses inhibited like that. So, there will be a slight echo as the camera picks up the exact same thing that was said several seconds previous. Bit more of the black gray. I think we can probably go straight black gray, actually. I don't think there's any reason to mix anymore. I may have done that on the pecs, but the pecs were a much larger area and needed a lot more work on them. The back here, for the most part, is in shadow, with the exception of this upper area here, going to about, the halfway point down the back. So there's not a whole lot of highlighting that needs to be done there, and definitely not a whole lot of blending. The arms, however, are a different story. Okay. Alright, so I know where I am. So, 5-minute yoga break starts now. Let me put this where you guys can actually see it. Let me prop him up on something to give him some... That's really not helpful. Can we prop him up in a way that you can... Can you stay like that? That'd be freaking awesome. Can you stand up like that? Probably not. Can you stay, please? That's pretty good. You guys can still see that. Okay, cool. Give me like 5 minutes. I'm going to stretch. I would advise you to do the same if you've been sitting for a while. As Jim Rohn used to say, the mind can only absorb what the seat can endure. Good morning, Underdog Painting. How are you today? Alright. Have no fear. I have returned. To the camera, please. Oh, about knocked it over. Okay, so we need dark gray, which is convenient because that's what he's sitting on. Fantastic. Let's just mix a little bit of this in right here. Just right here. All right. Let's get some water in the brush and mix this crap together. Oh, that is really, really light. Way lighter than I wanted. That'll work, I guess. Alright. Rinse the brush out. I'm assuming that's Celsius, or is that, that can't possibly be Fahrenheit, right? I might actually have to go to the London Gray on this one. It's just not got that same brightness that the pecs and the abs and everything had to them. That's okay though. We can modify our painting style as needed. Good lord, dark gray. Throw your paints, folks. That's a great way to shake them. It's my tip of the day, by the way. That's free. And if you can launch them at a person, that gets them even better shook up. So, yeah. Well, thank you, sir. Appreciate that. People tend to complain that I take too long on miniatures, but I like to blend. Well, let me rephrase. I like to layer, let's put it that way. And layering takes a long time sometimes. It's not a fast little 10-minute deal like a lot of people want it to be. Sometimes it can take 4 or 5 hours to do a single area, you know? I still laugh every time I put up a High Elf Chariot video. There's always somebody that comments on it. One of them is like, you're 75 videos in and this thing's still not done. Nope, sorry, not done. You're going to want to go to someone else's channel that has much more swift painting skills. Namely because I'll get really bored of painting the same color. That's it in a nutshell. And because of the way I work, I can kind of match colors pretty darn well. So there's no need for me to do all of the same color at once. You know, with the reason being that I might lose a color. I kind of know, I've only got three colors in front of me. I've got dark gray, black gray, and London gray. And so I know that I start here and I highlight with this mixed with dark gray until I get to straight dark gray. And then I highlight with dark gray. And then I mix dark gray with London gray until I get to straight London gray. And then I highlight with just a little bit of straight London gray. And on average, it's going to take me about 8 to 9 and maybe 10 layers to do. So I kind of know the pattern. And if I know the pattern, I can repeat it anytime I need to. So there's no real need for me to do all of the skin tone at once. So if I was doing like the color that I'm doing right now, if I had to do it on every single skin area at the same time, oh, I'd be freaking nuts. But on top of that, just from the simple, hello, please don't fall over. That's actually, you know, I hadn't thought about it, but I have not knocked the model over one time this whole live stream. I did it like 9 times on the other one. The other reason is muscle memory. And I learned this a long, long time ago. So basically, think about it this way. If I go over, let's just take this front section here, all right? So if I'm painting the pecs and the ab area, and I do, let's say I choose my, whatever my first highlight color is, and I do all the skin at once, and then I come back and I do the second highlight all over the skin, all right? Basically, every time I get to this area right here, I'm going to have to think about how to do it and where to put my brush strokes. However, if I do just this area and I highlight just this area, I remember it's here, 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 and I'm done. And then I go to the next color. And I remember because it's so recent in my memory that I can come back right to the exact same areas that I was highlighting previously, and I know right where to put the highlight, and it makes the highlighting much, much quicker that way, for me at least. Now, again, it, you know, just to each his own, but for me, it seems to work better that way. You paint how you paint, you would tell Salvador Dali to change the way he painted. I wouldn't, no. Then again, I'm not a big Dali fan. Alright, let's see. Who else? What else do we need? I need now dark gray mixed with London gray. Come on. Out of the bottle, please. There we go. That's good enough. Mix a little bit of London into that. Alright, here we are. That's fine. I have no problem sharing how I paint. For the most part, anyway. Now, there's certain things that I've done on film before, like on a DVD, and I won't say how I do stuff, just because I've done it on a DVD and like you can purchase it and figure out how to do it, but you know, a lot of stuff, it's real simple. You know, if it's just a question, I don't mind answering. Alrighty. I believe that might be good enough. Although, I suppose I could add in one more highlight. Oh, why not? Why not indeed? London Grey, please. By the way, for those of you Brits out there who missed it earlier, I'm using London Grey. Feel free to cheer. A really bright highlight, and it's probably gonna suck everything up. But let's see. Little bit, tiny bit, tiny bits. Don't want much of this at all. Holy cow. That's a really bright color. Okay. There. Let's do this show, good God. This is not a Games Workshop piece. We don't need highlights like that. I need subtlety. Alright. I think that's reasonable. Let's come in. There's still some of that black glaze left, so... Actually, no, there's not. It's dry. Well, that sucks. Whatever. Alright, cool. So, we have the front done, and we have the back done. I like it. Alright. Okay, now we do... Well, let's see. Should we do the arms or the face? I think the arms, since I'm kind of been working on the upper torso anyway, I think it's a good place to start. So let's do the arms. Two arms. Actually, let's not do the arms yet. Let's try to figure out a better blue while we... See, the problem I've got is I've got this puddle on the palette. It's got to kind of dry before I can do another puddle on top of it. So, let's do the blue. Let's work on the blue. At least figure out what color to use, because Andrea Blue, pretty as it may be, is not going to work. Let us choose Intense Blue instead. Or perhaps Dark Blue. Dark Prussian Blue, even. Maybe. I'll get that one out too, just to be safe. I'll even pull Oxford Blue out. See, look, there's another British thing. Alright. Apart from Games Workshop, what brands are people most enjoying these days? I hear Coca-Cola's pretty big. Mars as well. Miniature wise, I don't know. Do I prefer to paint open miniatures or closed pose miniatures? It really depends on the model, the brand, the genre. There's a lot of factors that go into that one. I mean, a mountain of factors. Now, if I had my choice, I'd probably pick something a little more open just because I like being able to access everything with the brush. However, there are some miniatures that look really, really nice that are closed. Not many of them that I've seen, but there are some. But I tend to like being able to access everything with my brush, so an open miniature is, generally speaking, kind of the direction that I would go. Alright, so that works much, much better. I don't know if I'll use that or not. But about to start a big Protoss Games Warzone Resurrection product. Oh, you are going to like something that I'm going to do later on this year. I actually do not have any of the Warzone Resurrection stuff. However, I do have a massive, and I mean massive, array of original Warzone models from Heartbreaker Hobbies way back in the day. And they are absolutely gorgeous. And I'm going to be showcasing them right here on this channel. Did I just pull the exact same color? I think I did. Ah! Too much color. Alright. So what I'm going to do here is gently, and I mean gently, paint one half of the spear in blue to give myself another reference point for the blue. That's not too bad. Okay. That's true, some of it was really substandard. I do admit, though, I love the old models. A lot of them, anyway. There's a few of them that I would love to have, but I just don't know. I wasn't able to pick them up. And the company that makes them now, I don't think sells them anymore. Let's see, what do I have from Bauhaus? I can't remember. I know my favorite kits that I've got. I've got a set of Venusian Rangers, which are amazing. I have a box of purple sharks, which are unbelievably beautiful. And then there's I can't remember what they're called, but they're basically female versions of, like, Wolverine. They're covered in chains. They would be wonderful in Necromunda, but I can't remember what their names are. I love those too. Let's see, Omar, are you getting those from your eBay or your own collection? Either of those pretty much looks the same. Let's try something odd and go with Oxford Blue. Just see what it looks like, because I'm curious. It looks like a bunch of bubbles right now, because that's all that's coming out of the eyedropper bottle. Oh, let's see here. That could be fun. Sort of a purplish kind of a color. That might be kind of interesting. Let me lay that out in this section here. Nope. Hell no. Nope. See how quick that decision came about? Let's mix these two together, see what happens. No, it's not magic. That's definitely what it is. Or what it's not, at least. Although I like the color. This is like Gene Steeler skin tone kind of color, which is pretty darn cool, to be honest with you. Let's try that. Nope. That is so, so not what I was looking for. I gotta admit, I am a fan of metal. I don't know what it is. I feel like I'm gonna break a plastic miniature if I paint one. They're flimsy feeling. Nothing wrong with them, but they're just. I like something heavy. Like this guy right here, he probably weighs half a pound. Well, maybe not half a pound. A couple of ounces at least. He's got some bulk to him, you know? Anyway, oh, by the way, was everyone here when I did the Harbinger preview? If not, feel free to let me know, and I'll do it again. Yeah, that Oxford blue, sorry guys, that's just not gonna happen. What's my favorite metal band? Let's see. Gosh. Man, that's a tough one. Metal band. I don't know. It'd be tough to pick one. Although I suppose what I would consider metal is probably not what everybody else would consider metal. So. Very true. Blue Tack. It's basically also known as poster putty. Basically just a very sticky, almost like silly putty type substance that people use to put posters on walls, and it works really well at holding miniatures onto a temporary base. See, I like Metallica, but I'm not a huge fan. I'm more of a fan of AOR than I am of actual what most people would consider metal. So I suppose for me the closest thing to metal that I really enjoyed would be something like Poison. Although I do like Avenged Sevenfold. That's probably fairly metal. To some extent anyway. And then I like the 1990s version of Ozzy Osbourne. Not a huge fan of the current version, but all right, what are we doing? Let's do the arms. Let's do, I guess I'll probably do the hand too, since it's kind of up there. He wasn't what? Oh, that's right. I gotta mix this with black. Ah, yes, the plumbing issue. Yes, everything is resolved, I suppose. At least for now. Yeah, there's something inherently idiotic about whoever installed the pipes underneath the house putting a right angle turn in the pipes. If I ever find out who did it, I'm probably going to kill him. Or her. Okay. Let's do the arms. Let's make sure I'm in frame before I actually start painting. That's a good thing, right? Here's a bicep. Has anybody in this chat ever heard of I can't really say ever heard of, but I guess have anybody in this chat ever heard of a relatively new line called Legends of Signum? If not, they are essentially many of the Rackham sculptors have finally gotten back together and begun to recreate new models for what amounts to the Rackham line, although they're manufactured under a different name by a Russian company. Beautiful, beautiful miniatures. There's a company I miss dearly, Rackham. If you never saw my Friday Afternoon Figures video about Rackham, I would encourage you to go watch it. Alright, Underdog, have a lovely rest of the day. Enjoy, hopefully, your day off. And enjoy time with the family. Because they got greedy, that's why. It's like Reaper, to a lesser extent anyway. Although Reaper didn't completely jump the shark. Back in the mid-2000s, Reaper launched a line of models called the Warlord line. It was a line for their brand new skirmish-style wargame. And it lasted about, oh, I don't know, 3, 4, 5 years. They still sell the Warlord line, but they haven't produced anything new for the line since, I think, like 2010 or so. But they basically built the line to boost their game that they had created, and then when the game failed, they kind of just forgot about the line of minis. It's a great line, though. Really good line of minis. Who, Rackham stuff? You talking about on eBay? There are, let's just say there are other avenues for acquiring Rackham models. You have to look around a little bit, but eBay is not your friend, if that's what you're looking for. And when the company is belly up, I have absolutely zero problem with those other avenues. I know some people do, but when you run a company and you're too stupid to run it correctly so that you lose your entire product line, I'm sorry, but if someone else comes along and says, you know what, I've got some of those that I bought and I'm just going to cast them myself and sell them, I got no problem with it. Especially when the company's been gone for over 10 years. Okay, so let's see here. Bones, miniatures. Let's start with the bones, and then I'll talk about Reaper paints. Okay, bones. Now, you gotta realize this is one person's opinion. Bones are one of the worst models that I have ever dealt with in my entire life. I mean, they're hideous. The way they're cast in a very strange resin plastic hybrid, and you have, when you get them, they're almost, the models almost feel like rubber. You can actually bend them, and they'll spring back into place. You have to work with them a lot if you have, I mean, for instance, if you had this spear right here and you got the miniature and the spear was bent over like this, basically what you would have to do is get yourself a cup of boiling hot water, dunk the model in for like 20 or 30 seconds to expand the molecules in the rubber compound, pull him out, bend the spear back into place, and while you're holding it in place, dunk him in a cup of ice water. And it basically shocks everything, jerks it back together, kind of like you're forging a sword. And if you're really lucky, it will at least take some of the curve out. It's almost never going to be perfectly straight. And I absolutely hate Reaper bones. To me, it's one of the worst things that Reaper has ever put on the market. Aside from their paint, which Mr. Wolf has just asked about. So let's talk about the Reaper Master Series paints. They're awful. Now, granted, again, one person's opinion doesn't mean that you're not going to like them. But I have had 5 or 6 of them. I still have a few of them here. And it's possible that the formulation has changed since I used them. However, when I used them, they had just come out. And I used them to paint several different miniatures, or in combination with my Vallejo stuff. And the problem that I had with them is that there is an additive that a lot of painters use if they want to cheat. And I say that because if you listen to Jeremy Bonamont Taboul, one of the best painters in the world, he says the only thing you need to thin your paints is water. That's the only thing anybody should ever use. But there is an additive called Flow Improver, and there's another additive called Drying Retarder. And a lot of painters like these things. Basically, Flow Improver breaks down the adhesion of the paint to itself, and so it makes it flow across the miniature very easily. And Drying Retarder extends the time that it takes for your paint to dry once you have placed it onto the miniature. The problem is, Reaper's Master Series has both of these things already mixed into it. And they're mixed in a quantity and a ratio that, for the paints that I had anyway, once they did dry on the miniature, they dried in the same manner as you would see a dry lake bed, where it's very cracked and speckled, and that's what my miniatures looked like. And it was not a pleasant experience, not one I would choose to repeat, and I try to shy people away from Reaper Master Series any chance I get. There are better paints out there that will not cause you heartache. Hope that helps some. By the way, if you'd like to try some Reaper Bones, I actually have the entire original Reaper Bones Kickstarter that I am going to be selling very, very soon. I'm going to be starting up some eBay auctions because I need to get some money together for, like I said earlier, purchasing a brand new laptop and some other stuff as well for this channel. And so again, if anybody's interested in buying a DVD, feel free to do so. However, I'm going to be doing some eBay auctions coming up very, very soon, within the next couple of weeks. And in those auctions, one of the things I'm going to be auctioning off is going to be all of my Reaper Bones models from the Bones line. And if you want to pick some up for inexpensive prices, definitely look for those auctions. Yeah, actually, I did a review several years ago on the Reaper line. I think it was called Vallejo versus Reaper or something like that. And I got a ton of heat. I mean, a mountain of heat from fanboys of Reaper. But it's like, hey, look, I love Reaper miniatures. I love Reaper metal miniatures, let's be specific, although Bones didn't exist at that time. But I love Reaper miniatures, but this paint line is garbage. They had a wonderful line of paints called Pro Paints. They were in regular bottles, like you would see Games Workshop type stuff in. They were not eyedropper bottles, just regular standard paint pots. And they were amazingly wonderful paints. And then they hired a new painter who somehow convinced Ed, the CEO of Reaper, to let her create a brand new line of paints for them. And she did, and the rest is unfortunately history, because the Pro Paint line is no longer available, which is very unfortunate. My dark gray is sticky. It's tacky. It's not wanting to come out of the paint jar. But you know, in the end, whether I take heat or not for something, I need to get you guys the truth, and sometimes the truth is just not comfortable. It's like when I did the review of Miniature Painting Secrets with Natalia. I don't know how many of you ever saw that, but that was not a comfortable review to see or to do even, but it had to be done, it needed to be said. I mean, I wish I could love every product, but unfortunately I can't do it. I just recently got a how to paint book from Scale 75 Paints, or from the Scale 75 company, and it's substandard. Love their paints, but the book is definitely not worth the 30 or 40 bucks, whatever it was. And so I'll get around to doing a review on it at some point, and I hate to do a negative review, but it deserves it. Love the company, love most of their products, love their miniatures, but this one was a strikeout. I don't know, is that a recent one, James? It may be one that I've actually got. If it's one of the originals, of course. Alright, I think that's pretty good on the arms. I don't want the arms to get too bright because they're not the focal point of the miniature. The focal point's the main chest area, the face, and then the two weapons on the side. So I think we're pretty good right there. Let's take a minute now and... Well, I guess I could do the hand, and I really need to do the face, too. So I was going to say, let me go ahead and do the glaze, but I'll hold off on that temporarily. Let's see here. How about we stand up? That's a good thing. Let's do that real quick. Everybody stand up. Probably going to go for maybe another 30 minutes or so, and then, much as I hate to do it, I think I'm going to hit the bed myself. I got to be up at 6 o'clock in the morning, which will be 3 hours from 30 minutes from now. I got to be at work at 8, so. It's a fun miniature, though. Really, really, really liking this guy. Just added in a email in the video description. If anybody's interested in donating, there's my PayPal account right there. I don't have a way to do it in the chat yet. I know that a lot of people don't necessarily want a DVD, but they do like supporting the channel, and that's fine. So, if you want to. Not saying you have to. 48-hour shift start at 8 a.m. What do you do, James? Firefighter? Nurse? Oil rig worker? Ah, good morning from Lithuania. Wow, that is a very, very rare place to hear someone from. Cool. Good to have you here, Zilvis. Morning, Rambo. Oh, very cool. Very cool, James. Okay. So, by the way, for those of you just joining us, here's what we have so far. Still got a ways to go. Just sort of blocking in some colors for the lower half of the body right now, working on the highlights on the skin tone for the upper half. Well, the fur tone, I suppose. At some point, I don't know when, I'll come in and paint that really cool spear. And I got a lot of filigree work down here on the bottom edge of this, this piece of cloth here too. But lots of cool stuff on this miniature. Oh, and by the way, I think I talked about this earlier, but I don't think I ever showed him again. I showed it to the first crowd that showed up here. I did the base in a desert style base. I wanted it to match my Harbinger of Osiris. Many of you have been watching the Harbinger of Osiris Watch Me Work series. I wanted to give you a little sneak preview at the final product. Since there's only 4 videos left, I've kind of been holding off on putting them up until I can get around to doing another Tuesday Watch Me Work. But if you want to see the final product, here he is. So enjoy. So they kind of match one another, although they are part of different factions in the War Gods game. But the bases, like I said, kind of, I wanted them to sort of be the same. So for those of you that are interested, well, there's a big height difference in these guys too, looks like. Not too bad. I guess this guy's helmet just makes him a little bit taller, but really, really cool stuff. Love these Crocodile Games minis. All right, set him back over there. All right. If you're not watching the Watch Me Work series, or any of them that we do, definitely check them out, because it's kind of like these live streams here. It's all just unedited, raw footage. Usually 20 minutes at a time, where I go through a miniature from primer all the way through finishing. Try and upload one episode per miniature per week. And so some of them are going to last, you know, a year. Some of them maybe 2 or 3, depending on how many videos it takes. Haven't seen Knights of the Realm in a Let's Paint for a while. What is Knights of the Realm? I remember Lords of the Realm. That was a subpar Sierra computer game back in the 1990s. I don't know Knights of the Realm, though. Ah, Bretonians. Bretonians. That's right. That's that's the guys with the funny headdresses on. I know what you're talking about. Gotcha. Okay, yep. All right, so let's do something. What are we gonna do? I almost want to do the face before I do the hand or the legs. There's still a black spot there, though. Let me fix that real quick. This, like, right in there. I think that's pretty good. Poke into the mouth a little bit there, too. Rinse that off. Okay. I'm almost tempted now to go back and repaint the hair a different color, like the long hair, not the short fur. It's just very, very similar to everything. Although maybe once I apply the wash to everything, maybe the hair will stand out even more. Otherwise, I'm going to have to come in and make it a little bit lighter. But for right now, we'll leave it as is. Somehow I'm going to have to wash the face, even though I've already painted the eyes. That just occurred to me. That'll be entertaining.
Not sure I'm going to pull that one off.
Well, that's okay. All right. Let's block out some more colors while I'm waiting on this to dry. Maybe my browns. Where are my browns? Let's see here. Tell you what. First, let's put some paint away. How about that? Because I got way too much of it out. That. I need the blues. I don't need the desert colors out anymore. We can put all that away. Put it all away. Let's see here. That's that one. That goes there. And then there's this. Where's the other one? There's that one. Alright. That one maybe goes there, actually. And then this one goes over here. Always put your toys away, kids. And 25 goes up here. Wonderful. I'll set those two back there because I don't feel like bending over to get the other. To get to the other one. Alright, now give me a brown. Where's my brown? That would be this one, please. Open. This guy, hang on 1 second, let me get some paint on the palette and I'll show you. Alright, hang on. This guy belongs to a line of miniatures called War Gods of Egyptus. It's by a company called Crocodile Games, and this is the Harbinger of Bast, sculpted by a guy named Todd Harris. Crocodile Games got a ton of really amazing miniatures. I definitely encourage people to check them out. It's crocodilegames.com. Lots and lots and lots of really cool stuff over there. Definitely check them out if you like unique miniatures. All right. What did I just do? I just got some brown out. I was like, what the hell am I doing? I don't know. I don't know anything. All right. I need to water it down some. Okay, so let's paint. What in the frick is that? That's his headdress. There we go. Alright. That was the word frick, by the way. Is frick even a word? I don't know. I'll use it because I don't want to use the other one. So everything I'm painting brown right now is going to be gold eventually. So just to help you wrap your mind around it. Certain areas of life that I might know more than somebody, but I like to go through life with the philosophy that every man can be my teacher at something. Not every woman, though. Not every woman. That's a shame. I'm just kidding. They can teach me things like how to cook and how to clean, how to mend socks, all kinds of useful skills. Okay, let's see here. Now, see, I would really like for the spear to be gold, but I don't think it's going to work. I kind of wanted it to be
the same as this guy.
Sort of the same as this guy. Kind of like that kind of feel. But I think it's going to work better if this part is gold and then the spear itself is silver, because it's going to match the sickle, which is over here, which has not been attached to the miniature. If I can get to it, can I please have the, can I have the freaking weapon, please? Thank you very much. Jeez, my table's like being clingy all of a sudden. Oops. It's a good thing that wasn't painted. Alright, see, I think it's going to be more cohesive if the sickle and the weapon are the same color. Now, if I want to do them both in gold, that's one thing, but if I want to do this thing in silver, then I kind of need to do this thing in silver too. Haven't quite decided what I'm going to do, but we'll get there. Who knows? I don't know when that'll be that we'll get there, but we will get there. Alright, so let's, at the very least, let's paint the, this whole, like, connecting area. How about that? Yeah, I'm kind of leaning towards the gold, so just haven't made that commitment yet. Got a long way to go. Oh, hello. Careful. Can we please not get paint where it's not supposed to go? Jeez. Pay attention, Christopher. Do it right the first time and you won't have to do it again. So we'll kind of go in that direction for right now, and then, this gigantic mass of whatever this is in the center, this whole thing is not going to get painted gold. I'm actually going to take, I don't know if you can, let me kind of kill some of the light. You might be able to see it, you might not. You probably can't see it. Okay, so, like, on the sides of the brown stripe that I just put right in the center, they're like these horizontal slashes running all the way from the bottom all the way to the top. And what I'm going to do is alternate back and forth, back and forth, back and forth with red and blue gemstones, because that's going to be freaking amazing, even if it is incredibly tedious and time-consuming. Go ahead and paint it all in brown for right now, just to get rid of that white, because the white's annoying me. It's invasive and not a good color to look at, because it's reflecting everything at me. By everything, I mean the lights from my table here. Alright, that's not bad. Okay, so we'll let that kind of dry now, and I think my palette has dried enough that I can use it again. It's a little odd, yeah. But I'm actually looking directly over the top of the camera, so it's not killing me. camera's low enough that, actually I'm going to pull it up just a hair anyway, but the camera is low enough that it's not that big of a deal. Although left and right is confusing me, because when I generally work with this, right is going left and left is going right. It's inverted. But not so with the camera directly in front of me. All right. So let me kind of cleanse my brush here for a moment. If you ever paint for a lengthy amount of time, you'll end up with like paint caked around the ferrule of the brush. What I like to do is just take my fingernail and just sort of push up right next to the ferrule and just push up on the bristles. And generally speaking, that tends to get rid of most of the caking. And kind of rinse the brush out just a little bit in your water. And kind of take my fingernail and just drag it around as I rotate the brush. Just leave it right on that ferrule connection. There we go. Alright, so let me set this to the side and mix up a little bit more of that skin tone color. We need some of that. We need some black. Alright, let me move this guy out of the way because he's being invasive. He's taking up space in my camera frame. Let's move that out of the way. Let's move these out of the way. That's better. Alright, so let's see. We need to work on the face. For that, I need to mix these two colors together. A little more black, please. All right, give me 1 second. Back to it. Let's see here. I need to move that brush out of the way. I need to get this brush in my hand. I think I asked this earlier, but I want to check just because it's kind of a new crowd. Or there's some new folks in here at least. How many of you guys are here because you've seen me before on YouTube? Versus how many of you are here because you read about this live stream on a forum post? Or how many of you are here just because you found this live stream on YouTube, like, just by looking around? Just curious. Always kind of intrigued to know where the crowd's coming from. That way I can kind of know sort of where to put my focus, I think would be a good way to put it. he's got life to him now. He's got a little bit of life to him. That's nice. Very cool. Heck, I should have done the face a while ago. Even just that first highlight, man, that is so nice looking. You know, 1 second, I gotta get the model closer to me because I have to paint right above his eyeball. There we go. Okay. Quick little brush stroke and we're done. Okay, a little bit of color right in there, maybe. Right in there. I gotta do the lip, too. I forgot about that one. Okay. Alright, very nice. Boy, that makes a huge difference, just like that. Hey, James, awesome. You found it just having a look-see around. That's cool. Glad you're here. Glad everybody's here, too, by the way. Ooh, careful. Way too much paint. My goodness, Christopher. What the hell, man? It's a beautiful face on this miniature. I mean, just absolutely fantastic. The sculptor did a great job, and I just realized that I didn't paint the ears last time. Means I get to go paint them this time. And hope that it doesn't look stupid that I missed a highlight. Too much paint. There we go. Am I in frame? Yeah. Alright, good. Paint along the mouth. Just a little bit. Give a little bit. Give a little bit of your love to me. Okay. All right. Pretty good. Oh, wow, we're up to 15. Fantastic. All right. It's most we've had all day. Welcome, everybody. Glad you're here. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know. And the thunder rolls, and the lightning strikes. Man, that's a downpour. Wow. Hey, I'm not going to complain, though. Glad it's not a drought situation. We've had a drought like 3-4 years in a row now, if I remember correctly, so very thankful for the rain. I may come back in. I'm not really sure. I'll have to go look at some pictures of some cats. But I may come back in and paint the lower lip pink. I think it would help out a little bit to separate the lip from the goatee. Oh no, I tend to paint individual miniatures. I tend to spend, I don't know, 10-12 hours on each model, minimum. On a small model like this, so doing an army would be an insanely tedious task. Although, I will admit, for those of you that had been following me for a while, there may or may not be a very soon-to-be-resurrected Wood Elves project. Just FYI. Not saying it's definitely going to happen, but the likelihood is, if I had to give it a percentage, in the high 90s. What's next? Next is some black gray mixed with dark gray, because that's what we do. Be ones from Warhammer. I did a project, or attempted to do a project, years ago that I called Project Wood Elves, where I was going to paint an entire Wood Elves army in 30 days. And it failed miserably. Namely because I'm lazy. But it's been something I've been wanting to get back to, and last June, July, whatever it was, when they released the new Ilariel and some of the other Wood Elf miniatures, it really inspired me to kind of start working on the project again, and it's been something that's been on my mind ever since. So I'll be starting work on it again very, very soon, actually. I don't suspect that I'll be able to get it done in 30 days, like was my original intent, but I've got a plan in place to do it in a particular time frame, but I won't say what the time frame is right now, because it'll kind of give away something else I'm going to be working on. Sort of a case of, I want to get, or I'll have it done, not I want to get it done, but I'll have it done by the time this other model is done. Like, I'll have the entire army done by the time this one other miniature is done. Actually, two other miniatures. Good night. Good night. God bless. Have a lovely day. Lovely sleep if you're going to sleep. Now I need straight dark gray, which is going to be difficult to get because my dark gray looks like crap. Do I have another dark gray? That'd be really nice if I did. What is this laying down behind here? Is this a dark gray? Probably not. Nope, it's another London gray. That's okay. I'll deal with it. It's fine. I need to order another dark gray.
Welcome back, underdog.
Did you kick the kids out of the room, or you find your way free somehow, I guess? Or perhaps they're with you, sharing a fun family bonding moment. That'd be awesome. Couple of more highlights, and then I am calling it a day, I think. But I gotta get those highlights done first. Boy, this guy looks really freaking mean now that he's got a face. I kind of was thinking he was one of the good guys, but he looks like a jerk. Hey, sure thing, guys. Alright, let's see here. Now we need some London Grey. Woohoo, London. Alright. Are my British folks still in the room? I don't know. Underdog just showed back up, so yes, there's at least one British person in the room. Okay. So, now we need some really stark highlights. Really Tony Stark highlights. quick little bits of edge highlighting up on the ears just to kind of bring the points out a little bit. I might even do an unrealistic highlight kind of on the side of the ear just to help sort of define that that point there, even though light would literally never ever ever reflect off of that in that manner. Sometimes we have to fake it. Oh my, that's a very bright lip. Alright. Straight London Grey. I have not done this the entire night, but the face is always an area. It needs a little bit of extra care to bring into the limelight. Living in the limelight, and those who wish to be must put aside the indignation with the condemnation. Anyway, let's see what the chat's asking. Christopher, if you were to give advice to someone getting into the hobby, what would it be? Let's see. If I were to give advice to someone in the hobby, what would it be if they're just getting in? My personal advice, honestly, is don't listen to anybody. You're going to have a... Let's put it this way. There are a lot of people in this hobby who are unbelievable elitists. They kind of forget that, as my friend Dennis Waitley puts it, there never was a winner who wasn't a beginner. And there's some folks in the upper echelons that paint for competitions, and they paint really beautiful miniatures, but they don't understand, or they don't seem to remember when they were not as good. And if you post your miniatures to Cool Mini or Not, or various forums around the internet, you might not receive the welcoming, warm, loving response that you had expected. And so I would just caution you that if that happens, don't let it get you down. Continue, and as long as you're happy with the way your model looks, just keep on going. Now that looks freaking sweet. What kind of primer do I use? Zilvis, I use Armory spray primer. I've used it for close to 20 years. And it's the best primer that I've ever used in my entire life. It's just fantastic. I've tried other stuff in the past, but Armory leaves a little tooth, leaves kind of a gritty texture on the miniature, and it helps the paint stick to it. I've never seen another primer do that. I love it. Okay. Derek, welcome, welcome, welcome. It's good to have you here. I don't know how much longer I'll be here, but it is definitely good to see you. Okay, so now that I've got the vast majority of the upper torso done, let's take a moment. You know, I'm almost tempted to leave him like this, to be honest with you, and not even worry about the wash or the glaze. Gosh. I mean, he looks pretty darn cool as it is. He is a little on the light side, but it's not like obscenely light. Let's tone him down just a little bit. Or do I want to do that now, or do I want to wait?
Decisions.
I think I'm going to wait, actually. What I will do, though, before I leave, I'm going to go ahead and do the little bits of red on the side of the head, just to kind of get an idea of what that's going to do to the model when I add in those colors. And it may change my perception as to whether or not I need to paint the... what's the word I'm looking for? To do the glaze. How about that? And again, this is just a it's a placeholder red. It may not be the red that I actually use, but it's a similar color. So, let's see. Oh, that's right, Derek. You're my magic follower, aren't you? I forgot about that. See, I'm one of those that I'm learning how to draw, and it's easier now that I know sort of the ins and outs of painting and what makes a painting look good. It makes drawing much, much easier. However, I'm still nowhere near as good at drawing as I am with a paint and a brush. I gotta take a model off camera for just a second. Sorry. I need access to an area that I can't get to because the camera's in the way. So, that's alright. We'll fix it quickly. There we go. And I guess, let me go ahead and do that too. Hang on. Almost done. Don't worry. I'm coming back. Give me like 30 seconds. Okay, almost there. Oh dear God, please be careful. Don't get paint where it doesn't need to be. Hang on. Take him away again. Oh, please be careful. Please be careful. There we go. Perfect. Ish. Perk. Alright, well that's pretty darn cool. Let's move him into frame. Here, I will, let me go get my my Sketcheroonie book that only has two sketches in it. Hang on one second. So this is when I decided that I would learn how to draw. This was last year sometime. And I only did two things, but it's still something I've got a passion for and will get back to after I finish up a couple things that I need to take care of in life. But let me move him out of the way temporarily. So I know from painting the basic concepts of light and shadow. Hey, it's 3:15 for me, so that's cool. Alright, so let's see. I need to take this up. How do I do this? Let's come up and let's swing this back. That's pretty darn close, I guess. And that is gonna wash everything out. So let's move the... How in the hell am I gonna do this? Now let's do this. There we go. Okay, that's better. So, all I did was I bought a pencil set from a local craft shop called Michael's. Tested all the various pencils in various forms of pressure, and then tested them out, knowing what I know about how light and shadows work, and created a couple of cubes, and then went from there to a sort of pseudo drawing of my own hand, although I only made it to the thumb in the end. However, I think it actually works well. Let me kind of back this up, because it gives me a perspective of this is how we start by drawing basic geometric shapes, moving into what something can become. Although I'm not unbelievably happy with the way the thumb turned out, because my thumbnail is much longer than that, and so I screwed that part of it up. So I made some notes at the bottom as to what to work on, breaking down objects into basic shapes, master the art of object scale. See, look at that. So, let's see what else came after that. And then there was this one. This was the next, I think this was a couple of nights later. I worked on a nose. And I know that a nose is basically two cylinders with flares at the top of one and rounded edges at the bottom of the other. So, laid it out pretty simply and said, all right, that's not too bad. That's a good first try. This was two nights later doing the same thing. So, using what I know about painting and how light and shadow interacts has made drawing so much easier for me. But I still have a long way to go. So, anyway, let me swing this back in so the camera doesn't overtip itself, and then turn these lights back around. Hello. Come on, turn around. There you go. Thank you. You too. Turn around. There we go. Perfect. Kind of. All right. Let's see here. Alright, so what was I doing? I was working on a miniature. Am I still in frame? Of course not, because I jacked the camera up by being a dork. Alright, so how am I going to... Where in the... Oh, yeah, I'm looking at the YouTube stream. I'm an idiot. I can't look at the YouTube stream. I have to look at my own software. Otherwise, there's a 10-second delay. There's no... There's a reason things are not moving on the screen. Alright, so overall, not too bad looking. Torso up, anyway. Really all I did was the skin, which kind of irritates me. I wanted to do more than that, but I had a mountain of stream issues when I first got started. So, that's okay. It is 3:15 in the morning, though, and so I think I'm going to hang it up here as much as I don't want to. I do have to be up at 6 o'clock so I can be at work at 8. So I can live on 2.5 hours of sleep. That's not that big of a deal. To bring this guy back in, though, if you're interested, that's the completed Harbinger of Osiris. Been done for a while. I've been kind of holding off on uploading the final videos from that series just because it's a limited number of videos. There's only 4 of them left, and I don't have anything to replace that series with on Tuesday yet, so I have to wait until I sort of start another Watch Me Work series for Tuesdays before this guy gets finished up. But if you want to see him, there you go. I brought him out initially to show everybody at the beginning that the bases were similar in style because I wanted them to kind of have the same Egyptian desert sort of feel. But anyway, I think we'll call that a video, guys. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Assuming there is a comment section. I don't even know if there is a comment section on this thing. If you're watching it after the live stream, there's definitely a comment section. But make sure to leave a thumbs up on this video, too, when it goes live. And that's all I got for you guys today, just about. Again, if you're interested in helping support the channel, there is a my PayPal email address in the video description. Feel free to make a small donation if you'd like to. That would be awesome. It'd help this channel keep going and keep providing content for you guys. If you want to pick up one of my How to Paint DVDs, you're welcome to do that as well. The link from my website is in the video description also. And you can learn how to paint like this in no time at all, to be honest with you. A quick 5 or 6 hour journey through one of my DVDs, and I guarantee you can produce something just about exactly like I've done here this evening, or just about like this guy over here who I didn't do this evening. Or if you want another example, feel free to here, have a look at this guy. This is going to be the next start to finish miniature. Just a sneak preview for those of you that are in the live stream this evening. This is Charandras. Very incredible, awesome looking striking scorpion model. You guys are gonna have a lot of fun seeing that when it comes out. But ton of fun to paint several months back, but always keep him on my desk because he's cool looking. Let's see, let's answer some chat questions quick. Let's see, any news on Masterpiece Miniatures Volume 2? All right, Jonathan, so here's the deal on Masterpiece Miniatures Volume 2. Let me put the cat in front of you guys while I'm talking. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and refilm Masterpiece Miniatures Volume 1, but I'm going to do it in HD because the original is in standard definition, and frankly, it is something that needs to be in HD. Once that's done, I will move on to Volume 2. I hope to have Masterpiece Miniatures Volume 1 in HD done before the end of the year. And if everything goes according to the plan that I've laid out, should have Volume 2 done hopefully by summer of next year, and then maybe a Volume 3 after that as well. Who knows? I don't. But I've got a plan at least, and hopefully that plan will come to fruition. For now, though, I will leave you guys, and I thank you so very much for entertaining me this evening and for letting me entertain you. I really do appreciate it. It means a ton to me. And I thank you very, very much for watching me and for thinking that I am worthwhile to be watched. That, like I said, that means a lot to me. So I thank you once again. God bless you all. Have an absolutely incredible rest of your day. And I will see you all in the next video.